Welcome to Excitement.com and our discussion on No Bounce Borders. We've all seen the videos. They even made the local news. Axes bouncing back at the customers. At best, this is bad for business. You've probably had people that, after seeing these videos, they're afraid to come throw. And realistically, in time, one of these throwers will not be as lucky and someone will get seriously hurt. We have developed a solution to stop axes from coming back at the customers. We really can't take credit for it. The answer dates back 300 years to the pioneer of the study of motion, Sir Isaac Newton. You've probably seen a Newton's cradle, which demonstrates the principle of conservation of momentum, which is mass times speed. This principle states that when two objects collide, the total momentum of the objects before the collision is equal to the total momentum of the objects after the collision. In other words, when the first ball of Newton's cradle collides with the second, the first ball stops, but its momentum is not lost. It's just transferred to the second ball, then the third, then the fourth, until it reaches the last ball. To stop the axe from coming back at us, instead of having a solid object like the floor and a board on the wall, we simply need to give it a movable object to hit. By suspending our patent-pending no-bounce borders, the momentum, again mass times speed, is transferred to the border. Because the border has so much more mass to move, by the law of physics, the speed has to drop. This means the axe falls harmlessly to the floor as it does not have enough energy, speed, or momentum left to come back at the thrower. Watch in slow motion as the border gives under the energy of the axe, and as the momentum is transferred, the axe falls to the ground. Just like Newton's cradle, if objects are all solid like a floor in the wood wall, the energy and momentum is transferred back to the axe. But if we let the momentum transfer into the no-bounce border, it removes the energy from the axe and it does not return it. Besides making the throwing experience safer, the other advantage of the no-bounce border is that you don't have to replace the boards below your target all the time. Since so many new throwers hit low, these boards normally get chopped up, creating lots of splinters to clean up on the floor and give the lanes a used, torn up, and shabby look. Since we surround the entire target with our no-bounce border, they also make an excellent surface for our projected scoreboard that also displays a lane timer and your logo, making pictures in the lanes an excellent marketing vehicle for your business. If you'd like to offer a safer experience for your customers while cutting the cost of replacing boards, plus take advantage of the other features of the patent-pending no-bounce borders, reach out to us anytime at excitement.com.